But I want to take you now for a special report coming in from Uttar Pradesh. It's not yet over. It's the fear of the pack of wolves. They come around midnight, in darkness, and they prey against children specifically. They've targeted about 8 to 9 children already, and the attacks continue. This is when shooters have been deployed. There's a full-on Operation Bhediya that is currently in full swing in Bharej. It's the terror of the wolves in Bharej district specifically. These are several villages, remember, where wolf sightings have been confirmed. Attacks have left farmers, parents of young children in a state of fear. Now, in the latest, as you look on your screens, the 10-year-old boy was attacked by a man-eater wolf last night, right outside his house in the village. But the child eventually was saved by the villagers, who pulled him back and rushed him to the hospital immediately. In turn, what has happened is 24-hour patrol in the villages by the local residents. A total 18 shooters have been deployed. Forest Department is using thermal drones to spot the wolves at night. Villagers have been strictly advised to keep their children safe, especially during the nights. So this, remember, is a massive animal-human conflict and a bizarre development, menacing wolf threat in the villages of Bharej.
This is night patrolling being done on a tractor where I am right now. All these people are villagers, the volunteers, they're helping out. They've been involved by the Forest Department, have been told that you have to get onto a tractor and let these announcements reach every nook and corner of all of these villages. On the left side of me are sugarcane fields where we see many of these wolves essentially hiding. They're able to camouflage themselves very well here. Some of these are villagers, and many of them have been in fact working with the Forest Department as well. Let's get a sense from them about what is going on here. कितने देर देर रात तक यहाँ पर इस तरह से आप लोग पेट्रोलिंग करते हैं?
रात 9 बजे से सुबह 5 बजे तक हम लोग पेट्रोलिंग करते रहते हैं।
कितने दिन तक ये चलेगा, आपको क्या लगता है? इससे क्या भेड़िया डर जाता है या लोगों पे अवेयरनेस पहुँचती है कि वो जान जाते हैं कि इस तरीके से बाहर नहीं सोना?
आवाज आती है तो गाँव वाले भी जग जाते हैं और आवाज से भेड़िया भी डर के खेतों में भाग जाता है, इसीलिए हम लोग पेट्रोलिंग करते हैं रेडियो के साथ में।
लेकिन ये कब तक चलेगा?
ये कोई फिक्स नहीं है मैम, जब तक भेड़िया पकड़ा नहीं जाता है तब तक ये पेट्रोलिंग चलती रहेगी।
आप कुछ बताएंगे साथ उठ रहे हैं आप लोग, क्या कुछ दिखाई नहीं पड़ा? दिखाई नहीं पड़ा।
तमाम जो लोग,
इससे आप गन से कितना दूर तक फायर कर सकते हैं?
350 मीटर।
350 मीटर। तो ये आप लोग का क्या काम दिया गया? शूटेड साइड अगर भेड़िया दिखता है तो मार देना है
जी,
आराम से नहीं सकता, मतलब अगर भेड़िया दिखता है तो उसको मार देना है
जी जी जी।
तो क्या भेड़िया साइट हुआ था?
दिखाई नहीं पड़ा।
कितना दूर तक इसकी गोली जाती है इस गन की?
350 मीटर।
तो किस तरह से आप लोगों ने घेरा था उसको भेड़िया को?
चारों तरफ से घेरा था, लेकिन वहाँ पे थाने लोकेट हुआ, घाम की वजह से वो कैमरे में सही आया नहीं। सीआर का बच्चा था, वही बैठा था।
अच्छा, आप लोगों ने ड्रोन में देखा सीआर का बच्चा था, आप लोगों को लगा भेड़िया है?
जी जी।
तो आप लोग पहुँच गए वहाँ पे?
पहुँच गए वहाँ पे, लगाया गया। इतनी मेहनत करने के बावजूद सीआर निकला हुआ।
और शूटर्स भी थे, शार्प शूटर आए थे?
हाँ, शार्प शूटर।
कितने शार्प शूटर आए थे?
वहाँ 5-6 लोग हैं।
रात में वही 9 बज रहा था, यहाँ दुकान के पास से गुजरा, फिर अंदर गया तो वहाँ शोर मचाया, लोग मतलब रपटाए। तो
दुकान के पास से किधर से गुजरा?
इधर से सर।
इधर से?
जी जी। और वही रात में 9 बज रहा था, फिर गांव में घुस गया तो वहाँ बकरी उकरी थी, तो वहाँ बकरी को मतलब ये कम नोचने ओचने लगा। उसके बाद गांव के सब लोग थे वहाँ रपटाने लगे।
यहीं पर पास में उसकी मांद भी बनी है?
नहीं, वो चहलारी घाट में मतलब उधर रेत में। जी जी सर।
अब हम लोग तो ऐसी त्रासदी से पहले तो देखा नहीं, आते थे पहले भी आते थे, बकरी वकरी अगर कहीं पा गए मौका तो बकरी वकरी लेके चले गए। एक एक अभी 2-3 महीने पहले एक बकरी को पकड़ा था, लेकिन ये जो आदमखोर वाली व्यवस्था ये पहले नहीं देखा गया था।
So this is no childhood imaginary tale. This is a reality for the villagers in Bharej, where a pack of wolves are hunting for little children. Now here's what has happened in the latest that we have from on the ground. Now the wolves have turned aggressive. They are man-eaters right now. And after killing of the pups, that is the information that has come. That is why it is being mentioned as a sort of a revenge killing, that it appears that some pups or smaller wolves have been targeted or have been taken in. And that's why there has been this hunting that is on. According to experts who are mentioning about this animal-human conflict, they say that 2 wolf pups were crushed by a tractor recently because these wolves may have entered into residential or human territories. wolves' recent loss of habitat as well. Again, like I'm talking about the conflict here, remember that this is increasing about as more and more areas that are made into residential localities. It is also about the habitat of the wildlife that is getting encroached upon. Now, the wolves appear to be, according to experts, are seeking revenge, unlike other predators, and that is why the aggressive nature, that's why they are hunting for children. They believe this is sort of a revenge attack. Now, the hunting of children seen as an act of revenge, according to the wildlife experts, and therefore there will have to be a lot of deliberation to be done on this. It's wolves today. There have been other animals in this case as well, and this is an ongoing issue that does pertain specifically to the village areas. Now, for a special telecast, India Today's Sneha Mordani decided to venture into these villages, spoke to the villagers, stood with them at midnight in darkness to help understand what is the fear about. Here's her special report.
This is the village which has been in news for all the wrong reasons for weeks together right now. Wolves have been attacking the people here, then compelling the authorities to arrive at the conclusion that they have turned man-eaters, because it's not one, it's not two, it's been several attacks, Children are the victims of these wolves. They're vulnerable and wolves find them easy prey. I'm coming to you from Behraich right now. This village, like I said, which has been in news for the wrong reasons, not just in India, but outside of India also, given that world over, there are concerns over wolves attacking animals and how this has turned into a major animal-human conflict. Right behind me, the fields of Behraich. These are the sugarcane fields from where the wolves essentially are known to hide. Operation Bhedia is also on, of the UP administration and the Forest Department, wherein they're making an effort to catch these wolves. There's been a fair amount of success, but the sad bit is that the attacks here continue and villagers continue to live in fear.
क्या नाम है आपका?
हमारा नाम है उधम सिंह।
ये उधम सिंह जी, बताइए, अचानक से आप लोग के हिसाब से भेड़िए ऐसे क्यों अटैक कर रहे हैं? बच्चों के साथ, भेड़ियों के बच्चों के साथ कुछ लेना देना? आप गन्ने के बारे में भी कुछ बताए, गन्ने के खेत के बारे में भी बताए।
गन्ने के खेत में बच्चे भाट फाट रखे, वो बच्चे जोत हो गए थे, खेत जोत ही गए। हाँ हाँ, भेड़िए के बच्चे, खेत की जुताई हुई रही थी, उसके बाद वो मर गए उसी के तरफ से।
ये कब हुआ? ये कब हुआ?
गर्मी में हुआ।
दिस इज द प्लेस ऑफ 2-year-old प्रतिभा, हु वाज किल्ड ऑन द 27th ऑफ ऑगस्ट बाय अ वुल्फ, टेकन अवे फ्रॉम द फील्ड्स राइट फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर स्पॉट where the family was at about 2 or 3 in the morning is what they tell us. The wolf came exactly from this route where I am right now and dragged the child away. Just give you a sense of what the parents here are saying. These are the parents of Pratibha, the baby who was killed by the wolf. And just right here is what the parents are telling us. The wolf, every single day, even after the attack, chooses this spot. This spot, takes this particular route is what they're telling us. ये बताइए राकेश जी, उस रात क्या हुआ? आपने कहा बच्चे को सवेरे ही उठा लिया था, बहुत ही सवेरे था, 2 या 3 बजे का समय था।
जी वही 3:10 का समय था। मेरी बेटी ने पानी मांगा तो इसने घर से लेके आया, वहाँ पे बैठाल दिया, फिर नल ढारने लगी, उतनी देर में दबोच के ले गया भेड़िया। फिर तुरंत हमको आवाज मिली, चिल्लाई, मैं तुरंत दौड़ा तो इस जगह पे दिखी हमको, पानी में जाता हुआ दिखा, फिर मैं दौड़ा तुरंत, लेकिन वो कुछ सीधे भागा। तो फिर मैंने घर पे आया, टार्च लेके और डंडे लेके दौड़ा, तो सीधे नहीं गया, वो भाग गया था दक्षिण की तरफ पे।
This village has just so many stories. Stories of children being taken away and accountability being fixed in terms of some compensation being given to villagers, the family members who've been left behind. But this family doesn't even have the solace of that monetary compensation, of that
help from the administration or their help from the government. They lost their child, perhaps to a wolf attack. That's what they say. But because the body of the child was never found, it's not counted as a wolf attack. And hence, they've not been compensated. Aapke bachche ko, aapke poti ko, aap keh rahe the ki bhediya utha le gaya. Lekin kabhi bhi एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ने पुलिस ने इस केस को भेड़िया अटैक का माना ही नहीं माना कि भेड़िया ने हमला किया
हम भेड़िया हमला किया कोई नहीं माना हाँ कोई नहीं
माना क्यों ऐसे बोल रहे थे आपको
अब ना ही माने तो कोनो पाँच भाई कोई पैसा कौड़ी दे वाला हो तो देती रहती तो मनती और मुर्दा धुर्दार माने तो कहा जाए माने
The kind of warnings. Jagte raho, savdhan, beware, be careful. Be careful of the fact that there is a wild animal, more than one, and that it's turned a man-eater. Do not sleep outside your houses. Do not make yourself vulnerable. Keep your children safe. Lock up the doors of the house. If you do not have doors, construct doors. These are the kind of warnings that is blaring across loudspeakers. These are members, workers of the forest department, villagers have come all together to help solve this problem, to warn the villagers, to help keep them safe. And all of them are telling us that things like these, warnings like these will continue over a period of time. Yet another wolf attack. This time it involves a 10-year-old Sangam who's been injured. Thankfully, the eyewitnesses here, the mother and the aunt of the child, saw the child, heard the child make noise. And that's when they came out running out of the house. The aunt of the child has seen the wolf attack and saw the wolf escape after the child made noise. And the woman here, the aunt, who stepped out of the house to then save the child. Ab bataiye. अब कह रही थी कि यह 8 बजे हुआ कुछ समय पहले हुआ है हुआ क्या आपने क्या देखा
अरे हम देखा जी सही हो अरे एक जब नोचने लगी दरवाजे के पास पहुंचना तो नोचने लगी जब सब कोई दौड़न तो भेड़िया भाग लिया
कितना बड़ा था भेड़िया है आप श्योर थे कि वो भेड़िया ही था
इतना बड़ा भेड़िया था हाँ।
तो फिर क्या हुआ क्या देखा आपने बच्चे को कितना चोट लगा हुआ था
बच्चा के लिए है गाल में लगी है ऐसे लगी है ऐसे
द डॉक्टर्स द चाइल्ड इज ओके बट जस्ट स्पीक्स वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ हाउ The attacks are only increasing here. Remember, this comes in spite of so many warnings and so many precautions being taken in many parts of this particular area where the forest department is at it when it comes to creating awareness. But the attacks from wolves continues unabated. With video journalist Sanjay and Ram Sneha Moldani in Behraj for India Today TV.